Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and today we're going to take a look at Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7 and the BTRFS and really seeing how easy it is to add new devices to existing file systems. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me at theurbanpenguin, and on Facebook you'll be able to find and like my page as The Urban Penguin. So we're working with beta 3 of the RHEL7 product, and I've installed it with the default proposal for a BTRFS file system. If we look at the output from df-ht, we've got the BTRFS on SDA3, and that's mounted both to home and through to root. So that might be a little bit strange to you. The boot partition was partitioned up with XFS from SGI. BTRFS can have something called subvolumes. The idea of subvolumes is if I can set different properties for the one file system. And we have a single file system, SDA3, and we can see that through the file system's UUID, which we use for mounting within the FS tab. We can see it's the same UUID, but we just give it a different subvolume name. We could then set different subvolume options for home and for root. So ultimately we have one partition that is mounted to the two locations. When we look at our standard fdisk tool, so if I do an fdisk minus L on a second disk that I've added to my machine, SDB, we can see that currently it's unpartitioned. So we've got a 5 gig virtual disk that I've added to the machine and there's no partition, so it's just raw SDB. If we want to add this through to our SDA3 partition, that's in home and root, we then run the command BTRFS device add slash dev and then SDB, or SDB in this case. And we're just saying where we're adding it to. I can use home or root. Once we've added it, we need to make sure that we spread the file system across both disks. So we run the command BTRFS file system balance and then slash home. But because this is a shared file system, it actually has to balance the whole of the root and home file system. It's only a new install, so it's not particularly big, so probably isn't taking much more than a couple of gigs, so isn't going to take too much time. I paused the recording for a little while there, but it did take less than a few minutes. Now when we look at the output from df-ht, we can see that we've got 19 gig then available on SDA3, which is represented by home and root. So it's a very simple process to be able to extend your file systems. I do accept this is not fault tolerant, but it's a very simple demonstration of how easily it is to add devices to BTRFS. And even though BTRFS have been available for a few years now, and I've had videos available on my YouTube channel for a few years, it's significant that this is now in the enterprise product, so it's recognized by Red Hat as stable and supportable.